On pin number 3 of the button, we have the voltage VBAT-SYS. This voltage is present both in the EFP MIC and in the PMIC. Remember that any integrated circuit is composed of areas. So, a specific zone can stop working and the others can work perfectly. How does a power button work? It's very easy. When we press the button, the voltage of 4.3 volts goes to ground, making the device understand that a high state, 4.3 volts, has been changed to a low state. I to the data. On many occasions, you can have voltage on the button and the device doesn't turn on. The voltage must always be correct, otherwise the device doesn't turn on. The VBAT-SYS voltage is present in all these components, in our case a bobbin. This big capacitor is 100 nF and supports a voltage up to 25 volts. No voltage is detected on the battery connector, so it can be concluded that the problem might be in some sector of the EFP-MIC. This problem is very common in Android devices. Any repair about half an hour can cost between 60 and 150 euros depending on the phone range. On the other hand, in the OVP, input and output voltage is detected, indicating that there are no failures in this sector. We return to the EFP-MIC, which is responsible for delivering current to the battery connector. It seems that this sector is damaged, causing the lack of voltage. Detecting a breakdown can be a complicated process, but with the right resources, it can be diagnosed quickly. While it's not necessary to have a thermal camera, it is useful to have a schematic to identify the problem. In less than 5 minutes, I could diagnose the fault. However, I prefer to explain it in a simple way. With the help of the thermal camera, we can verify if the EFP-MIC is heating up. If it's so, the solution is to replace it with the new one, since, according to my experience, the load circuits such as PMIC and EFP-MIC tend to be damaged internally. On the other hand, other circuits such as audio, CPU and memory can be rewound to solve the problem. Not having a thermal camera does not mean that hotspots in electronic circuits cannot be detected. There is a simple method known as Rosin technique. In our channel there are several videos about this subject, and as well in YouTube you can find hundreds of explanatory videos. This technique consists of applying rosin in different areas and seeing which of the components heats up. When we connect the laboratory power supply to the battery connector, the input capacitors must have the battery voltage. However, the buck outputs don't have any voltage. When the device is turned on, the buck bobbin must have an output voltage, indicating that the PMIC works correctly. Therefore, if we have 10 outputs, we must measure the 10 outputs voltages on the bobbin. At the same time, we must have 10 inputs voltages on the capacitors. If we don't have a schematic diagram, we will count the inductors near to the PMIC to determine the inputs and outputs of the circuit. These inductors are present in all the mobile motherboards. At the same time, we will count the same number of boost line capacitors and we make sure that they are the same size. Then we will measure the boost line voltage to check if we have the correct input voltage. For this, we will measure the voltage of the capacitor of this line. Normally, the capacitor voltage is the same as the battery voltage without having to press the power button. Therefore, we will measure the voltage of each capacitor to make sure it is at the right value.